Good afternoon, everybody. Just a quick question. How many people are here from, as teachers and professors, and how many people from industry? Can I see some hands? So, most of you are students. I'm going to talk about completely different issues here. By the way, ICSID means the International Council for Societies of Industrial Design. That's the world body who deals with societies of industrial design, so not individual organizations, but NICC is member of ICSID, so that's just the background information. I'm going to talk about design, education, and the relation to the client, and a client can be anybody. Again, mainly it's industry or it's government. In Holland, okay. Is it loud enough or not? Okay. I cannot judge. So in Holland, for instance, the government used to be a formidable client because the government thought that if people pay taxes, then they deserve the best service possible. So I include, if I talk about clients, I include the government there. Oh, further away. Okay, is this better? Okay. The creative industries in the Netherlands, which is more or less comprising of all the creative professions from architecture to fashion to graphic design and product design, is one of the top sectors of the Dutch economy. It contributes, I think, more than 4 billion euros to the national brute product. And Holland is a country with a population the size of Delhi and geographical size of an area of Haryana. And it's a very knowledge-intensive economy. That means that we hardly have any manufacturing to do. So we try to build our income by using the knowledge and trying to consult others and help to build knowledge base by using research and science. We have selected top sectors, and as I said, the creative industries is one of them. And the creative industries in the Netherlands is world class. That means we are competing in the world in the area of creative industries. You might know famous names as Rem Koolhaas, the architect, Marcel Wanders is the designer, and you might know them. I hope so, you know them. And design is important, creative industries are important, because it is one of the major drivers for innovation, and that's what I'm going to talk about. I'm going to talk about that because India launches a big program. It's called the Decade of Innovation. And the Decade of Innovation means that it takes 10 years to develop the creative and by doing that, also the innovative capacity of India. And I promise you there's still a long, long way to go. And the growth in the Netherlands, the only choice we have because it's a mature society, we have to do that together. We have to look to other countries and collaborate with other countries. And if I look at India and the Netherlands, India is roughly about 80 times bigger than the Netherlands. India has 1.2 billion inhabitants, as you know, Holland 16 million. But if you look at the design competitiveness, Holland has 46,000 designers active in the market. In India, we don't know exactly, but it's estimated 4,000 to 5,000 designers active. While in Holland, we have about 40 design schools, of which two of them, at least Delft University of Technology, where I come from, and the Design Academy in Eindhoven, they are leading in the world. They are leading institutes in the world. While in India, we have 20 design educations, of which 8 have a certain name, and only one, maybe NID, has a kind of an international reputation. And if you look at the number of graduates, in Holland we graduate about 6, and how many are there in Canada, Michael? PhD. So that means also that there is a big scope for having a much higher level. I come back to that. So what important to know is that you are in high demand. So it's up to you what you do with it. I'm going to talk about that. And you have many different types of designers. we talk about author designers, designers who work for themselves, who are also innovative for themselves. This is the so-called Snotty Vase. It's designed by Marcel Wanders, and it is, in fact, a still from a video image when someone is sneezing. And he translated that into a ceramic product. So he blew it up, translated that in a model, had a rapid prototyping made. And this is, in fact, a phase where you can be very innovative in developing shape. But this is trying to innovate as a designer by yourselves. This is a so-called the wood chest. And the wood chest is made out of old cupboards and products, doors and drawers, etc., etc. And again, this is a kind of design which is very, very individual. It's very close to art. By the way, I'm going to talk mainly about product design because that is my background and that's the subject. But in parallel, everything what I'm going to tell is also valid for graphic design, for media design, etc. I hope so, at least. So, but in Holland, we focus very much on design for business. This talk also will focus on design for business. That means that designers are working for business, no matter whether it's the government or industry or other organizations. So you get paid for the job. And now suddenly there is a problem. And it's not only a problem in India, it's a problem everywhere where designers are active. There's a big problem between clients and designers. And if you don't solve it on two sides, it will be a very difficult relationship. Even in countries where we have a long tradition, it's very difficult to have a good relationship between the client and the designer. I can tell you in the 15 years I had my own company, design company in the Netherlands and Switzerland, I only once received one good design brief from client. Only once. And that's very surprising. So that means you have a role to play there. I'm going to talk about that role. And it is, you can apply it for products and services and systems. So, and design for business is a kind of, should be a management tool to at least achieve preset goals. You think that should be the reason that the client knows about those preset goals. It's not the case. So you should be in the lead. In many cases, you should be in the lead. You should try to figure out what are those goals that can be achieved. And many of those goals are not directly top of mind for industry, so you have to fill them in. Otherwise, it will be difficult. But for the company, it's about money, so reducing costs of products and processes. It's about time, how can we reduce time to market? It's about identity, strengthening the position of the brand or the position of the organization. And it's about competitiveness. How do I do compared to my competitors? Those are the main lines, but much and much more. There's hardly a company, hardly a company who is really interested in the user. They never talk to users. They talk to salespeople. They talk to marketing people, but they never talk to users. Later on, in the third part of my speech, I will come back to that by discussing a few projects. So Dutch design is cutting edge. But if I look at India and the Netherlands, how can we collaborate? There's an emerging design economy and design business in India, and there's a very mature and very well-developed site in the Netherlands. Since 2007, we tried to set up a collaboration. We have participated in all the design summit, in all the yatras, and now we are here, and we try to find a way to collaborate with India. And because of that innovation decade, suddenly the National Innovation Council, together with the National Design Council, they try to collaborate and figure out what's wrong in India. Why isn't it possible that we are on the world stage with what we are doing? Slowly, slowly, movie and fashion, they're entering the world stage. But even an idea is a reputed institute for more than 60 years now, I guess, more than 60 years, hardly has an international position. So what can we do without telling them you're doing things wrong? So we try to figure out all kinds of forms of collaboration. I'm going to show you something. Oh, maybe, Maya, is there a booklet there? Yeah. Akash, can I have that booklet? So, Sam Pitorda, the chairman of the National Innovation Council, addressed the Netherlands and said, can you please help us with further developing in Indian design education? And this is the result. I have 20 copies for, and I leave it to the organizers to share them with others. And I also leave the digital file with the organizers. So if students are interested, you can order that with NICC. You can just tap it from the website, I hope. Yeah? The idea is that it is a proposal in which India sets up a kind of a program for about more than 10 years. It's more than 10 years. No, it's less than 10 years. And it's called, indeed, Indian Design Education. And it's a proposal to enhance the growth and state-of-the-art design schools in India on one side, and what is important on one side, but the other side also to increase the design competencies of the client side, industry and government. And it's a result, and it's very important to notice, it's not just a design proposal, it's a result of intense collaboration between design experts in India and design experts in the Netherlands. Because otherwise, you get the idea of it's not invented here, and then it's very difficult in India to get things across. So, and this is not readable, but nevertheless. But it's in fact divided into three parts, 2012, 2014, 2015-17, 2018, 2020. And it's about design education on one hand and design awareness on the other hand. So in fact, two major programs. And this is the education side, where you have the stakeholders on the left side who all need to be involved in improving design education. It's students, it's teachers, schools and universities, is the design professionals, industry, government, other stakeholders, and most importantly, public. If you don't tell the public about the value of design, they never make good decisions. They don't take good decisions. So you have to start, what I said this morning about education in India, you have to start with the lowest level of education. You have to make people aware of making a good choice in life, whether to buy a sustainable product or not, whether to buy a product which has some standards of safety involved. So you have to educate people, otherwise they will never know. But the same stakeholders are also addressed in the awareness program. So you have to inform all those stakeholders and raising awareness about, for instance, the development or the state of the art of design worldwide. I hardly see international magazines in India. I hardly talk to students who know about the international collaboration. There are many fantastic websites of international organizations. For instance, if you go to the IDEO website, you have hundreds of pages of free information about design processes, about design thinking. I hardly talk with students, and they don't know about those pages. So this is part of it. And within those two programs, for education on one side and awareness on one and the other side, we have proposed many different projects. Until, for instance, launching big television programs about design, following designers. They did it with BBC, I think, about 10 years ago. And it was highly successful, not only to inform everybody who might be interested in becoming a designer, but also to inform the general public and, very important, the government. So we discussed, for instance, with Sam Pitorda, why not redesign a ministry? Can you imagine that a group of, an international group of designers, together with a big group of Indian designers, they just take one ministry. They redesign the building, make it accessible, gives it some kind of quality. They redesign the workspace. They redesign the energy consumption. They redesign the mentality of the people who work there, etc., etc. But they also redesign all the services supplied by that ministry for the government, just to set a big example. Maybe it's a good idea for NICC to pick that up. Okay.